PhotoDirector 10, which is developed by CyberLink, allows you to edit your photos and really make them jump. Now, if you got a DSLR camera, or if you've got a point-and-shoot camera or GoPro, one of the biggest tricks with shooting photos is shooting in RAW format. Some people will shoot in RAW and JPEG. I own a Canon 80D DSLR camera, and I always shoot in RAW. I do not shoot in JPEG. Now, RAW and JPEG simply means when you're shooting in JPEG, the camera does all the editing of the photo, and then it puts it in a JPEG format, and you're very limited in what you can edit. But if you shoot in strictly RAW, which will be in your camera settings, you can now manipulate that photo any way you choose and make it look just like the professionals do. So, in PhotoDirector 10, this is what the program is mainly used for. It's mainly used to make whatever photos you take look really good. When you get started with PhotoDirector 10, you're going to have to load your photos in. That is the first thing you're going to have to do. You're going to have to go up here where it says File, and then you're going to do an Import, is what you're going to do. Now, normally, I like to import a folder. And all you do is, once you click that, it's single-click the folder where all your photos are, and it will load them all in one shot. Or you can load single photos if you choose. Once your photos are loaded, after you've imported them, you're going to see this here. So File, Import, Folder, first thing. Get your photos in the program. We're going to immediately jump over to Adjustment. And then, right under Adjustment, we're going to go to Presets. That's all we got to do right there. So File, Folder, Adjustment, Presets. We're there. Now, we can manipulate our photos any way we choose. I prefer to click on the one you see here with all the tiny squares you see in PhotoDirector 10. Because what that'll do is that'll load all my photos in one shot, as you can see here. Now, once you have your photo, because it kind of looks like a little slideshow, you can choose whatever image you want, and now you can start messing with it. So let's say I want the herd of buffalo here. I just double click it, wait a few seconds, and it's going to try and make it look as pretty as possible. But if I don't like this, I can go on over here on the left side and check my presets. Now, it comes with a whole list of default presets by simply opening the arrow, and they all come down. If you don't like these presets, and you'll see a look of them there. You see that? I clicked that and it changed it. To go back to what I had, hit Control Z or Control Z, whatever country you're in, and that'll take you right back. So Control Z, Control Z are your favorite two keys when you're working in this. Or you can go to where you've downloaded presets from Director Zone, and a whole bunch of people have made some for you. This is one here I downloaded called Pre-164, and I think that one looks really nice. Now I can save that, and I can print that, or I can upload it to one of the many websites out there that'll print my photos and send them to me so I can put them in a frame. And you can really get fancy on how you edit these, as you see what I'm doing here. And this is how the professionals actually work on their photos. Everybody uses a different program, and there's all kinds of different programs out there to do this, but this is really made really easy. I mean, I was really amazed when I loaded up PhotoDirector 10 here and started playing with this. And again, go back to all the squares you see there, and now you can go and look at some of your other photos and see which ones you like. And then you can manipulate them, you can play with them, you can try and get whatever look you want when you're editing a photo. Like this photo here, I cut the head off. No good. Oh well. And you'll see how PhotoDirector tried to make it look as pretty as it could. So
So I'll go on back and look for a different one. So if you want to get great shots of your kids, of your family, your dogs, your cats, your pets, always shoot in RAW and then load it in the PhotoDirector 10, and now you can manipulate that photo to look really good. Now, of course, taking photos in the proper lighting is also very important. There is a thing that photographers refer to as golden hour, and this is 1 hour in the morning and 1 hour at night. These are literally your best times for taking photos with any camera. If you could remember to take your photos, if you're going to take photos of your dogs or your kids and do it 1 hour before dark and 1 hour in the morning, you are going to get a nice glow in your photos. And then when you pull it over here in PhotoDirector and load it up, and then you start editing your photos, they are going to snap. You're just going to go crazy wanting to frame photos all over your house once you start using PhotoDirector 10. Now, a lot of people shoot RAW and JPEG is what they'll do. And what I find when I do that with my DSLR Canon 80D, it actually is slower to putting the pictures on the SD card. So I only shoot in RAW, and then I will handpick whatever photos I like. I will load it into a program like PhotoDirector 10, and then I will pick whatever one I think is pretty. And then I will have that photo printed, and I will have that photo put in a frame and put it on the wall. And that is how the professionals make photos look professional, by simply using a program like PhotoDirector 10 by CyberLink. You want some more tutorials on PhotoDirector, guys, like cropping, removing red eye, whatnot? Give me a like, subscribe, and we'll see what we can get you. At any rate, guys, we'll catch you on the next one.